Hi guys, in this video I'm going to teach you a couple of basics about Speedcube hardware. There are so many different types of cubes and lubricants that it can be difficult for a beginner to figure out exactly what's going on. So the first thing that you want to note is that if you have a speed cube, most speed cubes can be tensioned and adjusted to your liking. So for example, if we lift up the center cap on any speed cube, so let's just do these two as an example, you'll notice that there'll be some sort of screw or other mechanism underneath the centerpiece. And what you can do is actually adjust this to become tighter or looser. So here in this one, we can turn this clockwise to tighten the cube, and once we do that, you'll actually feel that the layer is a little bit tighter and requires a little bit more force to move. You can also do it the other way, so loosen it like so, and then the layer will become slightly easier to move. Some cubes don't have a screw and have slightly different adjustment systems, but the principle is the same. You can turn it clockwise to tighten or anti-clockwise to loosen the cube. When you're adjusting your cube, you want to make sure that the tensions are even on all of the sides. So you don't want one slide to be significantly slower or faster than another side. So when you change your tensions, you want to actually take off all six center caps and do the exact same process, do the exact same adjustment to every single side. So let's say you want to adjust this by, you know, let's say 90 degrees. So you'll adjust that one by 90 degrees tighter. And you'll do the same thing for all of the six sides. However, if there's any imbalances, you want to just be able to fine tune that yourself. So for example, if you, go around the cube and find that one side is particularly loose or particularly tight, then you can adjust that side individually, but you want to make sure that all the sides are even. With regards to lubrication, there are so many different types of lubricants, and ultimately it comes down to your personal preference. So I would suggest trying out a few different lubricants if you can and seeing what works for you. Also note that some lubricants work particularly well in some cubes and not so well in other cubes, so you'll need to perhaps vary which types of lubricants you use in different cubes. So here's just two contrasting types of lubricants. So here we have Traxxas differential oil, 50k weight. And this is a really, really heavy lubricant. So you'll see that when I squeeze this out, it's actually quite viscous, like that. So it's actually still sticking, and we can get it down on paper like that. So yeah, it's a very viscous lubricant and it's quite heavy. So that's kind of designed more so to slow down your cube and make it a little bit more smooth. Whereas something like this is called Maru lubricant, is very watery. So if we do a drop, like that, you'll see that it's far less viscous than a 50k weight. And something like this is used primarily to actually help speed up your cubes and make them a whole lot faster. Generally, the more heavy lubricants actually last for a lot longer in your cubes, and the lighter ones don't last for quite as long. A really simple way to lubricate a Rubik's cube is to spread apart an edge and corner piece like this and put your finger in between it, and then do one drop at a time of lubricant. So one drop there, and let's test it and actually work it into the cube. So by doing a lot of moves, we can actually work the lubricant around the cube. And then if we feel like we need some more, we can do the same thing again. So open it up, put one drop in, work it around, and so on and so forth, until you feel like the cube is properly lubricated. But I would suggest that, yeah, you only do it one drop at a time. Don't put way too much lubricant in, because then you'll end up having to actually clean it all out, because the cube might end up quite terrible if you overload it with lubricant. Most modern speed cubes don't require lubrication too often. I generally do it around once every few weeks or once a month. However, if you're using a lighter lubricant, like something like a Maru lube, then you might have to put it in more frequently. So in conclusion, the two main ways in which you can adjust the performance and feel of a speed cube are to, number one, adjust the tensions by taking off the center cap and tightening or loosening the screw or other system there. And the second way is by lubricating your cube. And there's a range of different weights and types of lubricants which you can experiment with.